Okay, let's get
Yes,
started.
we can.
Okay, let's get started. So today's session is on project scheduling, right? So we're going to discuss about project scheduling. I will just close this. Yeah. So now, it's very likely that you guys know much more than me. So, but anyway, we can discuss and we can learn from each other, and possibly you can take some few items which can be useful to you. Okay, so now for being able to schedule a project, there is a step before this. There are many steps before this, but the immediate step before project scheduling is to create the work breakdown structure or WBS, right? So before we can make a project schedule, we must have a WBS. So I will start with a hypothetical WBS. So in a WBS, we need to have activities, right? We need to have activities which we will perform. So we need to have something called activities. Activities. I will increase the font size so that it's clear to all of you. Is it visible now?
Yeah, it is.
Okay. So we need to have activities. So let's take a hypothetical situation where we say we have these activities, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and H. Okay, so we have these activities with us right now. Let's add two more just for making a better case. Okay. Once we have the activities, the next thing what we need to do is that we need to estimate what would be the amount of time we would require to complete these activities. Okay, now all of you guys must be familiar with using Microsoft Project or Primavera or some project management tool like that, project scheduling tool like that. You may know that Microsoft Project, 80% of the software works on one formula. Can you tell me what is that formula?
You use the Gantt chart.
Yeah, Gantt chart is a report, but the tool works on one formula which it uses for 80% of the activities what it performs, or calculations what it performs. Anyway, let me tell you that this formula is nothing but work is equal to effort into number of resources. You trust me, you check Microsoft Project, 80% of the calculation what it does is based on this one simple formula, that work is equal to effort into number of resources. Okay. Now, so it is very important to first of all have the work breakdown structure, and against the activities what we have on the work breakdown structure, we must know how much amount of time we will take. Now, the amount of time that we put in a Microsoft Project is actually the duration into the number of resources is equal to the amount of work quantum what we will be performing on that particular activity. So next thing what we require is duration. So here we need to put the duration for each activity. I am putting some hypothetical figures. Let's say these durations are in number of days. So I'd say it is 10 days, this is 12 days, this is 15 days, this is 4 days, this is 6 days, and this is 20 days, this is 12 days, this is 7 days, and this is, okay. Let us say we have these durations for our activities. Okay. Now, project scheduling basically means that we have to be able to make a network. Okay. What is that network? It is known as the scheduling network. So we need to be able to make the scheduling network. Now, you may know that this is a question which comes in PMP. How many kinds of network diagrams can you prepare or are available to be prepared? So there used to be many network diagrams in the past, like Gantt chart is one of the network diagrams, which is very early adoption of preparing a project schedule. Gantt chart is a very old tool. It was basically formulated somewhere. I think I'm not wrong. It was formulated in Ford company. Anyway, I will verify that and I will let you know the exact thing when I am sure about it. Now, there are many tools, but the tool which became popular was known as a method called Arrow Activity on Arrow, AOA, Activity on Arrow. Now, Activity on Arrow is a networking tool for project scheduling, which became very popular. It was used for a very long time, and however, it had some serious limitations. This is something which we can discuss some other point of time, but you can also read up. Activity on Arrow is a networking tool which has some limitations, severe limitations. So to overcome those limitations, they came up with another networking method, which is known as precedence diagramming method, PDM. Now, the current method, what we follow, all the tools that you utilize, Microsoft Project or Primavera or any other tool like that which is available, all of these tools use the networking method known as precedence diagramming method, PDM. P for Parrot, D for Denmark, M for Mongolia. Okay, so in PDM, what we have is that every activity, we mark out what is the predecessor of that activity. Okay, we mark out what is the, that means which activity follows which activity, we should know that. So we need to mark out the predecessors. Now this is also should be familiar to you. In Microsoft Project, you always put the predecessors, right?
Yes.
Okay, so let's make some predecessors. So we say that this activity C follows activity A, and activity D follows activity A comma B. This means A and B. D cannot happen before A and B. Similarly, we said this is C, this is C, this is D. Okay. So let us say that these are the predecessors of the activities. Okay. Now, we need to discuss some theory here. A small bit of theory I will go through, which is very quickly. Now, when we have these predecessors, that time the predecessors can follow four kind of relationships. Okay. These predecessors can follow four kind of relationships. The most common relationship, if I do not specify what is the relationship, it defaults to something known as finish to start. Finish to start basically means that if I say that activity C has a finish to start relationship with activity A, it means that activity A has to finish and then activity C has to start. Okay?
Okay.
Now, similar to finish to start, we have another relationship which is known as finish to finish. Finish to finish. Finish to finish relationship basically means that if I say that activity C has a finish to finish relationship with activity A, that means to say that activity C and activity A must finish on the same day. Right? So activity A and activity C should finish on the same day. Okay. So then we have the third relationship, which is known as finish, which is known as start to start. Start to start relationship basically means that if I say that activity C has got a start to start relationship with activity A, it means that activity A and activity C should start at the same point of time. Okay? Should start at the same point of time. And last relationship what we have is known as start to finish. Start to finish basically means that the activity A, This is slightly confusing with finish to start, but nevertheless, this is to be understood. That is, if I say that activity C has got a start to finish relationship with activity A, that means activity C has to start when activity A is going to finish. So this is very rarely utilized and is normally confused with finish to start. Any questions so far?
No, it's clear to me.
Clear, right? Okay. So yes. I will remove this. Okay. So that is about, now these relationships are very important when we are making the diagram. Now, for the simplicity case, we will consider that all the relationships that we have set up, these are all finished, finished to start relationship. That is, one activity has to finish, then the next activity can start. Okay?
Okay.
Now, once we have this, we can create the network. So I will draw the network for you now for this particular thing. Let me just make this smaller. Oh, there's no way I can hide this. Anyway, this should be enough. So we can use this much. So this is enough. So once we have this, we can create the network diagram. Right. Now for network diagram, I will use some template. 1 minute. So now notice this. This is very important, this part. So I need to have a activity. Now in PDM, when we are doing precedence diagramming method, normally we represent the activity by a rectangle. Maybe this is not a rectangle. This is by a rectangle. So I can make a rectangle and I say this rectangle is named as activity A. Now for this rectangle, I need to put what is the duration of this activity. So I can make another small rectangle here and I color this. Okay. We were creating the network. So I put activity and I have put the duration. This is the normal notation you will find. You can check the normal notation, and I'm telling you the notation which PMP follows. So here we have one activity. So it has got a duration of 10 days. So now I will just create, I will use some of my PowerPoint skills. So I have this. Now I will create my next activity. So I see that activity B also does not have any predecessor. So I can put it in parallel here. So I say this is activity B and this is duration of 12 days. So here we have activity B, this is of 12 days. So now we have to create the next activity. Let's copy this and create another activity, that is activity C. Now we know that activity C has a predecessor in activity A, right? So I put it here. This is activity C. It has got a duration of 15 days. Now, activity C has a predecessor in A. So we in the network, we will put an arrow here saying that activity C follows activity A. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Now we have. Now you got the idea, right? So now let's complete the diagram. Now let's complete the network quickly. So activity D has got a predecessor in A and B. So how do we do that? We say that we copy this, create another activity. So this is D. It has got a duration of 4 days. And it has got two predecessors, right? So we need to put a predecessor from A to D and from B to D. Right. So this is how we have got the activity D, right? Now let's go to activity E. Activity E's predecessor is C. So I will clone this. It has got a duration of 6 days. And its predecessor is C, right? Let me push this little closer. And I have activity F. It's for 20 days. And this is also got a predecessor in C. So I drag arrow from here to here. Then we have G. G's predecessor is D. So I will take this and paste. This is G. Duration is 12 days. And the predecessor is right. Then let's quickly finish. We only got three more. H has got a predecessor in E. So I take this. H. Seven days. I let's change it to F, okay? So let's change the predecessor of I to F. I for I is F and this is and last we have J, which is a pretty, which has got H and I as a pretty. So I create this. For this. Okay, so now you have your network. Is it clear?
Yes.
So now we have our network, or this arrow has gone for a toss. Okay, now what, once we have this network, we need to do a number of calculations. The first thing we need to calculate is how much time will be required to complete this project, right? So that is the first thing we need to calculate. So for doing that, we need to traverse the network from the start to the finish of the network. So how do we do that? That is the question. To do that, start with the activity on the at the start of the project. In our case, it we always start from the left to right. However, with the whichever way you want to draw it, you need to start from where the project starts. So take the first activity here, that is activity A. So this activity is for 10 days, right? So the activity A, since it is the first activity in the project, it will always be the case that you will consider that this activity starts on day number one. Okay. So since it starts on day number one, I will say that I will put a figure here saying that this activity starts from day number one. Okay. Now, this activity will start from day number one, and for how long it will carry on? It will carry on for 10 days, right? So it will carry on for 10 days means this activity will finish on the 10th day, correct? So this activity completes on the 10th, starts on the first day and completes on the 10th day, right? Now, these two numbers, they have got a term. They are called by a particular term. The term which we use to call these numbers is known as this. This first number is known as the early start. Okay, so this number is called as early start. Okay. And this number, this we call it as the early finish. It will become clear why we call this early start and early finish. Give me a little bit of time. I will be able to explain to you why these are called start and early finish. It will become clear to you very soon. So this is the finish. Okay. Now, similarly, activity B is also the starting point of the project. So we will get that. This activity B actually starts on day number 1 and completes on day number 12. Right? No problems here?
Okay.
This is the early start for activity B and this is the early finish for activity B. Now let's go to activity C. So what do we do here? So now I will go to activity C. Activity C has the finish to start with A. That's what we said, right? So after A finishes, activity C will start. So activity C cannot start before the 10th day. It has to start on the 11th day. Right, that is the early finish of the predecessor activity plus one is the early start of the next activity. Does it become clear?
Yes.
Okay, now how do we calculate the early finish? This has got a formula.
Early plus 15.
Early start plus duration minus one. Right?
Yes.
So that's the formula. Early start plus duration minus one is the early finish. Now comes the tricky part. Activity D, we require early start and early finish for this, right? So now tell me, what is the early start for activity D and what is the early finish for activity D?
Start should be 11.
Okay.
But we have to check the B.
Yeah. So tell me what you
do. B 13, early start according to B 13. So we'll take the least one, that means 13?
No, it is not this. This is a good question. What we should take? We have two early starts here. According to activity A, it should be 11.
23.
Why?
You will add the P when it will finish.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, see here. This is the game. Here is where the relationship comes into picture. The relationship is that finish to start, right? Finish to start. Finish to start means D cannot start before A and B finishes. Correct? A finishes on day number 10, B finishes on day number 12. So we have to take, when if the both the relationships are finished to start, we have to take which is the maximum. When does both A and B definitely finish? That is when A and B both definitely finish. They will definitely finish on day number 12. So the earliest start will be day number 13. Did you get the idea?
Yeah, I get it.
Okay. Supposing my relationship was finish some other relationship. Let's say finish to start. Not finish to start. Finish to finish. In that case, you know, think about it. This is a problem for you. In other relationships, what will be the early start of the next activity? You apply yourself a little bit, you will get it. Right. Now, you have 13 plus 4, 17, minus 1, 16. Got it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, let's go to the next one. These are all simple. I kept only one case of difficulty for you. So, now can you tell me what is the early start of E?
Early start of E is
26.
26, correct. And early finish will be 26 plus 6, 32, minus 1, 31. Right?
Yeah. Correct.
F?
Twenty-six also.
Yes, absolutely. 26 plus 20, 46, 45, right?
Correct. Okay.
So now we can quickly go through this. I will not quiz you anymore.
28.
Yes. Yeah.
32. 38.
Right. 46. Oh, we have got a wrong this thing. G should be a predecessor for something. So G should be a predecessor for I. I will just rectify this. Otherwise, our diagram will not be correct. Right. We cannot have an activity which leads to nowhere. So still 46, right?
Yes, still 46.
Still 46. Now tell me, for J.
51.
51 is correct.
56.
Okay. So now you have got the early starts of all the activities and early finishes of all the activities. Can you tell me what is the duration of this project now?
52 days.
52 days, absolutely. So now this project has got a duration of 52 days. You got it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Now we have got that we can complete the project in 52 days. But let us see one more thing. Now, this what we have just done, this is known as forward pass. We have passed the network in the forward direction. This is known as forward pass. Okay. What we have done is the forward pass. Now, let us do the same activity what we did just now in the reverse direction. So when we do it in the reverse direction, That will be called what? Any guesses? That is called backward pass. Okay. So backward pass, what we will do is that we will take the duration of the final activity. It cannot have any other start date and end date, right? It has to have the same start date and end date. So this is the start date and end date of the last activity. This date which I put on the bottom now, this is known as late finish. That is the, this is the maximum day on which this activity can finish. So this is what we know as the late finish. Okay. And this date, what we have got here, 51, this is what we know as the, what do we call it? Tell me.
Let's start.
So this is known as the late start. Okay. Now we are going backwards. So this activity at the most can start on the 51st day. When this activity can at the most start on the 51st day, for activity H, when can it finish at the maximum?
38.
Why?
The latest.
Huh?
It's the latest number, 38.
No.
No, it is 50. It can delay.
51 minus 7.
51 minus?
For H?
Yeah.
7, minus 7.
Why minus 7? It has to finish one day before activity J, right? So it is 51 minus 1, 50 days.
50th day.
So if it can finish on 50th day, when should it start? When can it start at the latest?
7 minus 7, that means
43.
44, including 44, yes.
Late start minus duration plus 1.
Yes, 40 minus 1, yes.
You count 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50.
Yes.
7 days. Right?
Absolutely. Yes.
Okay. So now, Let's do it for activity I. This is I, right? I. Let's do it for activity I. So now tell me, what is the late finish for this?
50.
50, correct?
Yeah.
And then what is the late start?
The same thing, 46.
Okay, 46. You're right. Because 50 minus 5 plus 1 is 46. Now comes an interesting thing which we should notice. Notice here, this is got an early start 46, early finish 50, late start 46, late finish 50, right? Whereas this activity has got an early start 32, early finish 38, late start 44, late finish 50. Now, if we do a calculation, that is late finish minus late start. Okay, I write it down here.
Sorry, can you maximize the PowerPoint if we are not using the Excel so we can see clearly?
Now we don't require the Excel. I will maximize. Yeah. Better?
Yes, much better.
Yeah, much better.
Okay. Now take this. Late finish minus early finish for activity H, right? How much is it?
12.
12 days, right?
So you can start 12 days before, correct?
1 minute. So let me put it here. Let me put a circle here and color it something different.
Yellow.
This is 12 days, right?
Yeah, it was.
You can see still, right? I reduce the font a little bit. Okay. This is 12 days. This 12 days, that is late finish minus early finish. You see that even if I do late start minus early start, I get the same number. So this late finish minus early finish, this is known as the total float. This is the technical term for this is total float. What does total float mean? This is a very important question, CMP. Okay. Any idea what does the total float mean? You should be able to make out.
Yeah, it's the time that the maximum it can be late without interfering with the total project time.
Exactly. So this activity I can delay by so much amount of time without impacting the project's total duration. That is known as the total float of the activity. Okay?
Yes.
So now I already know that we calculated just some time back. What is the total float here?
Zero.
Zero. Zero. Right.
Thank you. Thanks.
So now let's do it for the next one. So what will be So what is the figure here?
There it is, 43.
46.
Yeah.
43, right?
Yes, yes.
And this one?
6. So
minus 6 plus 1.
38 is correct?
No.
Yes.
Ah, no? Correct, correct.
Yes, yes, correct.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. Okay, thank you. My arithmetic is not bad, huh? Still. Okay, this one.
This one is also same.
What? Why? How come?
45 and this thing?
45, same as this one, correct. Okay.
No, this is not this. Okay, this arrow is not visible. Okay.
Okay, what about this?
This is 45.
Five.
This one?
This one is minus 12.
34.
34? Right.
Yes.
Yes.
Let's take one difficult case now. Yeah. Now tell me. For activity C.
It is 37.
Think.
Which one?
Actually, correct. This is
25.
25. Because 25. It is
in the backward pass, when you have this, you have to take the minimum. Because this cannot, because both the activities have to be completed. Yes. Only then this can take place. Right. So this has to be 25.
25, yes.
The forward pass, we took the maximum. In the backward pass, we take the minimum. Right?
Correct. So
this one?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. 33. How much? 33. Right?
30, yes.
Yeah.
Okay, now tell me. How much?
10.
All agree? Huh?
Yes, 10, 10, 10, yes.
Okay.
One.
Last, we have activity B. How much is this?
29,
correct. Then this one.
Big difference for B.
Call it as it was.
Huh?
Big difference for B between the start, early start, and late start.
Yeah. Okay. Now, you got it. So now we have a network, right? We have completed the late start and late finish. So now tell me quickly. So what is the total float here?
12. Sorry.
Total float.
Late finish minus early finish.
Zero. I can see the first one. Click outside, please. Zero.
One.
Is it between the difference between the...
This one? E?
It is the late for this thing, no? Late finish minus early finish. So it is 12.
Correct?
It is. It is 0.
Let's finish this.
That is how much? 45 minus 28. 17.
Okay.
17.
This one is 0.
0? Yeah.
17.
This
is 0.
Zero.
And this is 17.
Right. Now we have got the early start, early finish, late start, late finish, and total float. Right? So we know which activities we can delay by how much, correct?
Yes.
Now, do you see anything significant in this diagram right now?
The difference in the activity B, D, and G, it's big.
Okay. What else? Okay. Do you notice that there are some activities which have got zero possibility of any delay?
Yes.
Yes. A, C, F, I, J.
No delay possible here, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Correct. There is no delay possible in activities. Correct? So,
correct.
Means to say that if I delay any of the activities where the total float is zero, my project will be affected. Correct?
Correct.
So, the activities which have got, let us see whether they connect with each other or not. Okay? Let us just check that. 1 minute. I am making a mistake. Okay, if I just paint this little differently, okay. So now I have got a line passing through all the activities, which are activities which I cannot delay at all, right?
Yes.
So this line which is passing through, it is a path, right? It is a path.
Critical path.
This is known as the critical path.
Yeah.
So the activities of the critical path cannot be delayed. And this is a very important question in PMP. Which will ask you, what is the total float of an activity on critical path? So what is the answer? Zero.
Zero.
Got it? Okay. One more aspect. Can I have more than one critical path in a network?
Yes.
It is possible. So as a project manager, if you see more than one critical path in a project network, what does it indicate to you?
Indicate means in what sense? That means it's...
What should you do? What does it... Why does it matter? If I have more than one critical path.
Yes, because there are two critical paths means there are two focal points, and if it meets in a common goal, then we have to provide for adequate resources and mitigate this.
The bottom line is that if there are more than one critical path in a project, then the project has got more activities which have got zero tolerance to delay.
Yes.
Right? If I have more activities but zero tolerance to delay, that means to say my project is going to be more risky. This is a huge...
Yes, I was about to say, yes.
Yeah, Shadi, tell me please.
Yeah, I was about to say we would be screwed if we have more than one critical path.
Yes, it is exactly. You would be screwed simply because this is how do you, now another way of asking the same question could be, how do you identify risks from a project network? Right? If I ask the same thing in a different manner, if I ask you, how do you identify risks from a project network? One of the risks which is obvious is that if the project has got more than one critical path, that is a risk. So if it is a risk, it has to have a mitigation plan also. So what is the mitigation plan in case you have more than one critical path?
We have to try to reduce the severity of the risk and make it less affecting the project. the impact would be less.
How?
We'll have to devise plans to make it less severe for the project.
You must reschedule the project. You must relook at the project durations. You must relook at the project activity durations, and then change the network so that you land up with only one critical path.
Yes.
That is the mitigation plan.
Okay.
Got it?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Now let us get back to Excel. Okay. Now we know what is the early start, what is early finish. So let us put that here. Early start, early finish.
Atho, one start. Question.
Yes.
Regarding duration, I think we will generally have the start date and end date, and then we find out the duration by deducting the send date minus start date.
This is the biggest mistake you will make in your life. Okay? This is the biggest mistake you will make in your life. Please do not do this. When you are using a tool like Microsoft Project, never touch the start date and end date. That is the job of Microsoft Project to calculate. You should only touch durations.
No, I am telling is about the start date.
Even the start date is, you should only give the project start date.
Yes. Not project start date, it will calculate automatically.
Calculate automatically. If you touch that, Microsoft Project loses all its capabilities to do any calculation.
And also, we should have this the calendar, the leave and other stuff.
That I will come to that in a separate session. That is not the thing right now.
Mm-hmm.
We will come to that separately. Okay. Now let's come back to Excel. So now let's try to calculate the early start, early finish, late start, and late finish. Okay? We can do that? Is it not?
Yes.
Yeah, we have the numbers.
So since we have the activity A with no predecessor, its early start will be 1. And same for activity B also, right?
Mm.
So what is the early finish? Can I put a formula? I told you.
Yes, it is 10, that means B2 minus D1 plus 1.
Huh? Where is minus?
No,
it
this
is
one.
Early start plus the duration.
Plus duration minus 1.
Minus 1. Mm-hmm.
Correct. So this is the formula for early finish. Now comes the early start for activity C.
Activity C, it is
11.
How do you get that?
It's
82 plus 1.
It is this plus 1. Predecessor, early finish, plus 1.
Plus 1, yes.
Correct.
Mm.
What about activity D?
A plus B. So it is B. So whichever is highest, that means B plus 1.
A2 plus 1.
Max of AN plus 1.
Yes.
Correct?
Yes.
Did you get it?
Yes.
Yes.
Look at this. This is the max of this plus 1, right?
Absolutely.
Now, what about E?
Yes, this one. Plus 1.
Correct?
Mm.
Now tell me this one.
Max of
E7, E8.
Right?
Plus